If you made it to this video, you're probably wondering how to install new seals on TFSI or TSI injectors. These are KO4 injectors. They're for the Golf R, same as on the Audi S3 AP. And so what tends to happen is if you're either you're upgrading injectors, okay, fine, you need new seals, gaskets, or you're doing some kind of service on the car, you remove the intake manifold, and one or two or all of them, the injectors, they come out with the manifold, right? And when this happens, we should do things properly to avoid having to redo it at a later time. I mean, we should change the seals and gaskets, right? So the first question is, do we need any special tool? Some people do this with the pens and whatnot. I would say you should definitely buy a special tool. And there's a kit from out of Volkswagen. There's various third-party kits, knockoffs, if you will. Not too expensive. I would say it's worth it regardless, because you really want to avoid having to redo this kind of job, right? This specific kit is from Nielsen. I put a link in the description. The other thing we need, of course, is the injector seal kit. Very expensive from Audi. This time around, I got a third party from Elring. I got these from Autodoc. So if you're in Europe, I'll share a little discount code in the description as well. You can get on Autodoc and get this kit. You need four of these kits though. They run about, say, €15 a piece per injector. And they contain the basket parts, if you will. They also contain plastic seal, the O-ring, and this O-ring tends to stay in the intake manifold, so make sure you remove those. And then finally, they contain the Teflon seal. I'm only going to replace the Teflon seal, this blue gasket here, and the O-ring. I'm not going to touch the basket. My baskets are fine. My injectors are pretty much in the new condition. So I'm going to leave this be. It's pretty solid if you have the latest revision. Let's have a look at the injector once assembled. So we've got the O-ring, blue plastic gasket, the basket, and then the Teflon seal. So this is going to be our reference. If we look at the install kit, it's actually an install as well as removal kit. We'll look at this for a sec. We have a brush piece here for cleaning the bore. And then you have removal and installation tools. You don't necessarily need the installation tool. You might need the removal tool if your injectors are really stuck. And then we have this, so let's go straight into installation. We have these cone-shaped pieces. And this kit is universal for Audi Volkswagen. You will not necessarily need all the pieces for your specific injector. For the KO3, KO4 injector, we're going to need this smaller cone. And there's an indentation here. It fits with the nozzle. It holds like this. What I found through trial and error was that straight out of this box, and again, this is a third-party product, the surface here is pretty rough. So what I did on the piece I'm actually going to use is I polished it, right? I don't know if you can see that, but I polished it to make it more smooth. Why is that? Well, the Teflon seal is going to be pushed across this and onto the injector. So we go like this, and we're going to be pushing the seal across and on top here. And then once it's across, we're going to use these tools here. One, I've just labeled them one and two. One is larger than two, so it goes gradually smaller. In the case of the KO3, KO4 injector, as far as I know, we're only going to use the first two here. So we're going to, the idea is we're going to push the Teflon seal across and then use these tools to gradually make the Teflon seal smaller so that it fits better across. And then the final seal, of course, will be once you install the injector into the cylinder head, right? What I also found through trial and error was that instead of using number one to push the Teflon seal on top of the injector, I found it was better to use my hand and to apply even pressure and just slide it across. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to use my fingers. I'm going to put on a bit of a latex glove here. So we'll do that. And you'll understand what I mean in a second. Okay, so we've got our cone. We take our Teflon seal, make sure it's where'd it go? Pick that guy up. Not ideal. Okay, make sure it's reasonably clean. Like that. Okay, slide it on. So this is our sort of our starting position here. Fit the cone onto the injector, hold steady, and I'm going to start applying pressure on the Teflon seal, holding this steady and pushing it across. Okay. And it's going to be expanding across the cone. There we go. So now I'll take my cone off and I'll put it back, right? Put these things back for now as well. And now the Teflon seal is fitted, but it's very loose. So that is not gonna seal against the cylinder head. So step two now is we take our first cylinder here and we're gonna press it over and then rotate. And I suppose this is actually an inverted cone, if you will. There's a cone inside here. It gets gradually smaller. And I suppose the friction or the heat generated will help shrink. So if you look at this now, go on top. Okay, that was no... that was not touching at all. So that doesn't help, right? So we go to our size 2, or I just label it size 2, the middle one. It's gonna be slightly tighter now. Put it on and it goes on. Goes over. At this point, I'll turn it. Give it a few turns. Okay, I'm gonna pull it off gently. And this might actually do. This might be enough to go into the cylinder head. And then of course the cylinder head against the surface is gonna press it for snug fit still. If I try size 3 here, it's actually pretty loose. So at least in my kit, that doesn't seem to do anything for this injector model. Give this a few more turns. Okay. And that's pretty much it. Make sure the surfaces are clean. I used some gasoline before starting this video. I cleaned the tip here, nozzle, and the rest of the injector. So what's left at this point? Well, we have to install the plastic gasket thing. And in principle, we should be able to rotate this on. Let's see how this goes. The smaller diameter surface goes towards the tip, let's say, and the larger towards the top here, okay? So let's see if I can do this. Just rotate, and that's it. Now we can take the O-ring, just gonna shake it for dust. And This one, it just goes on top pretty much. And there we go.